This is sometimes called the dead man's tuning. And I've never played with another fiddle player playing in this low D tuning. So,
well, neither have I.
That's right. So between us and Molly, it looks like 7 D strings are involved in this one. So we'll do one of the most famous of the traditional tunes that Copland used in his hoedown from Rodeo, which is a tune called Bonaparte's Retreat. And he got his version of that from a meticulous transcription by Ruth Crawford Seeger of a performance by a Kentucky fiddler named William Stepp that was recorded by Alan Lomax, and you can hear it on the YouTube. It's a wonderful thing to hear, especially if you know the Copland piece, because you can hear it. Boy, that's really exactly not only the tune that he used, but exactly the performance that he got his interpretation from. And we precede it by with an old waltz melody in the same tuning called Midnight on the Water. It's closely associated with Benny Thomason, the great Texas fiddler who Molly worked with in the years back. And it's a great honor for me to be on the same stage with Jay Unger and Molly Mason, whose music I've admired since I was just a lad.
That was just a couple of years ago.
That's right.
I do want to add that Alan Lomax did those field recordings during the 1930s, and it was part of the WPA. People were sent out to collect songs and instrumental music, quilt patterns, recipes, stories, to gather in the culture that was potentially disappearing. And it was all part of stimulus funding.